Yo, yo, we're halfway done with the workout. Made it through 3x150s. Don't know the time until we get back and check it on the video. My boy Fry, he cool, chilling. Got the spikes and tights on, ready to roll. Who this over there? This boo thing, say what's up? We're doing our thing, getting it working. 50 T, timeless. In case y'all ain't know. Tight. Peace. What's good, guys? Dee Brown with Track Kids, and I would like to welcome you to a very special, I want to call it an episode. I want to call it like maybe like a day in the life. You know, I'm over here at the track. You know what I'm saying? We're about to get started. I'm waiting on my boy Farad to come through because we have a nice little workout plan for us today. If you remember Farad, he was in one of the videos from like November, I want to say like October. You know, we did a workout 6x200s, really quality workout, and today we're going to follow up and we're going to get a pop in. Today we have 6x150s, a little bit faster, a little bit shorter, as you can tell, maybe a little bit warmer. Should be a quality workout. Can't wait. Wait for him to get here. He told me he's supposed to be here at 10. Right now it's 10:01. Where you at, son? Gotta wait for him. What's going on? But I'm patient. We're gonna see what's going on. In the meantime, I'm gonna put out these cones. You know what I'm saying? You have some people in the background. They're playing flag football. 18 and up, so that's looking cool. I'm gonna watch that. In the meantime, while I wait for Farad, and we're gonna get it popping. We should have a pretty good workout today. So stay tuned. Steve Brown with Track Kids. Look at this guy, he don't even know I'm on his blind side. Keep walking in here like he's not late. Look at that, now he just noticed. Alright guys, the man, the legend, Mr. Farad is finally here. We've been waiting patiently. You know what I'm saying? He's here. He's ready to get the workout in, man. How you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good. You know, I put a couple pounds on.
Put a couple pounds on. Last time y'all saw him, he looking swole. You know what I'm saying? But nah, it's going to be a great workout. We have 6x150s today. Last time you saw him, he did 6x200s with me. He did better than most. You know what I'm saying? So today, he brought his spikes. You know what I'm saying? He brought the Nike bag full of spikes. So he's ready to get some work. For real, we're gonna get some slow-mo for you guys, some fast-mo for you guys. You guys are gonna be thoroughly entertained, all right? So without ado, we're about to get the warm-up in, we're about to get the strides in, the drills in, and you will see us running pretty damn soon.
Did you update them on your performance last weekend?
Oh no, I need to do that too. That's gonna be a separate video because that was interesting. That was pretty interesting. We ain't gonna talk about that. We just gonna get the practicing in and then we're gonna keep it moving. All right, and I'm gonna see you in a couple minutes. Peace. We are done with the warm up. How you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good. My legs is not used to all that hurdle mobility. That's right.
Yeah, we were just finished doing some sprint technique work, high knees, butt kicks, A skips, A marches, straight leg bounds. Y'all know if y'all run track and field, y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. We just got finished doing those, and if you haven't done them in a while, they definitely got your hip flexors on fire a little bit. A lot of knee lift,
just a little bit.
A lot of knee flexion, a lot of, so, you know, we definitely gonna keep going. I brought a hurdle out here for the guard, and
with the hurdle?
Just in case you were tight, if you need some hip mobility. I also do leg swings before I do push-ups too, so that may help loosen you up. So yeah, we got everything out here. We're gonna keep going. It's starting to really warm up. It's probably like, what, in the 60s now? When we first started, it's in the 50s. So 65, so we're about to keep going. By the time we get started with this run, it's gonna be in the 70s, which is beautiful. I know if you're in New York, you hating. I know if you're in the Northeast, you hating. We're in Houston, we're getting a lot of this sunlight. You know what I'm saying? I might come back with a tan or something. All right, we're about to get started. See y'all soon. Yo, yo, we're halfway done with the workout. Made through 3x150s. Don't know the time until we get back and check it on the video. My boy Fry, he cool, chilling. Got the spikes and tights on, ready to roll. Who this over there? This boo thing, so what's up? We're doing our thing, getting it working. 50 T, timeless. In case y'all ain't know.
I didn't know you said it was coming to my house.
Tight. Peace. Finished the workout, 6x150s. Farad, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good. I cramped up. Was that the fourth one?
Yeah, the fourth one, yeah.
I cramped up on the fourth one. My calf caught a cramp. But I'm feeling pretty good. I'm pretty sure I'm going to feel this tomorrow morning. but it was a really good workout. I'm glad I really got some nice sprint works in. And it was pretty good. I'm just, my hips just kind of, they on the distress right now.
Yo, I was running with him, man, and Farad is no slouch. He was putting in the work. You see, he get, you know, he's in the weight room. He got bigger last time we've seen him. You know what I'm saying? Getting swollen and stuff. And this is what it's about, you know? Like, it's easy the first two, but then as you start to work through the runs and stuff, you know, you start feeling a whole lot better. And now it's Sunday. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Now you could just relax, have fun, drink. But he about to turn up, drink some of that dark. And he did his thing. Yo, I can't be mad. As for myself, the workout was good. Yo, it was great to have someone to run with because, you know, a lot of my workouts are solo.
Son, I don't know how this guy does it with training by yourself. Training by yourself, you just got to really, I guess, mentally prepare yourself because I can't just be that. My mental focus is not, I can't stay on that kind of consistency. It's just really tough. And I really commend this guy. He be out here working out by himself. And it's just really, really hard to just keep that mental build that mental toughness to be working out by yourself and challenging yourself throughout each interval. That's tough.
Yeah, it's definitely tough, man. Like I'm trying to keep the dream alive, you know what I'm saying? Like I'm trying to go to these meets and actually do something because, you know, I still have that passion for track and field, you know what I'm saying? So
I still got the passion for track.
But you had a hard event though. You got the 800. It's hard to train for 800 by yourself.
I'm 28 right now.
Right, yeah.
So if I started running again, I would definitely just stay strictly 400.
Yeah.
I would train. I would be doing 600s at practice, but I would definitely be training for the 400. Not the 800. That's the different kind of animal right there.
Yeah, it's tough, especially when you do those longer repeats and stuff. And it's one thing to not have teammates to train with. It's another thing to not have a coach either. So it's like, that's even harder. So, you know, I'm just happy that we're able to get this workout in. Like you see, it's great weather. It's 77 degrees.
Beautiful.
Like,
look at Houston right now.
I'm telling you, y'all hating right now. If y'all in the Northeast, man, to come on down. You know what I'm saying? As for myself, the workout was great. My last one was a little suspect. I think, I'm not sure what the hell that was. My hamstring made like a weird, it was something. Like it pulled or something. So I got to see what's up with that. But I've had a long cycle. Like it's been 4 long weeks of training hard. This is my hard week, so I can't wait to have a nice recovery week. But this was a great workout, you know what I'm saying?
Wait, hold up, though. What's your week gonna, what's this following week gonna look like?
So my following week, I only have one, well, I have to see how my hamstring is, but literally, like, today's Sunday, I'm off Monday, Tuesday.
Mind you, he was gonna go to the weight room.
Yeah, I was gonna go to the weight room today to finish it off, but I think I could just stick with core work. Monday, I have off. Tuesday, I was just gonna do, like, some repeat 200s, or no, I was gonna do, like, 6 times 100s at, like, 13 or faster. Like, that's not hard. And then I was gonna have, like, probably after that, 1 times 350, 1 times 200 at a fast pace, like 400 meter pace, and then I had the rest of the week off, like, yeah, a massage somewhere.
What would you say is your next upcoming meet?
I think that's gonna be February 15th.
Stay ahead of the game all the time.
Trying to. February 15th, I'm trying to run the 400 and 200. Like, my goal is to run 50.
Oh, you got the two events.
Yeah, my goal is to run 50 flat and 22.5. Wow. So, we're going to see how that goes. That's what I'm working towards.
Man, got his goal set already.
I'm trying to, man.
Tunnel
look,
vision right
trying
there.
Trying to, man. Start the new year off. Shit, if I can run 50 and 22.5, that means outdoor season. I'm trying to get back in the 40s, man. You know, like, trying to keep the dream alive. So, you know, and you also, what that Prairie View meet, you said you wanted to run in.
I'm actually not gonna be able to do that. I'm gonna be in actually Puerto Rico. That's the same weekend as my birthday.
This dude be traveling,
so,
man.
That is the weekend of my birthday, yeah. but I will try to keep in shape and try to keep. I told him I want to keep these weekends going and be consistent with just working out and keeping my sprint work. Yeah. Every weekend and keeping like some kind of running or some kind of cardio under me for the weekend. So I'm gonna be pushing that weight, trying to push that weight during the week. So.
And there's a lot of meets during that time too. I mean, Texas is full of meets. So shit, if it's one of those meets where we just happen to see a 4x4, maybe if he wants to overrun an open 2 or open 4 just for fun.
I'm definitely gonna do an open 4 for fun.
It's like, why not? You know, and I think he might surprise himself
I might try to get in the same heat.
For real, look, yo.
How that goes.
For real, bring it back, shit. We ain't running the same heat in
but
like
no, I definitely
so
would,
long.
I definitely would want to do that, though.
Yeah.
I definitely would want to try to do that. But probably like in April.
Yeah, April is when they start rolling, too.
April, and this is, you know, this is, is this World Champs here?
Olympic year.
Oh, no, this is Olympic year. Oh, yeah. It's 2020.
Yep.
Shit.
Olympic year, so. You know, it's people are gonna be flying. You know, they're gonna be meets in Houston, meets in Texas A&M.
Everybody coming out of the woodwork.
Right. Yeah. We ain't gonna talk about that, but yeah, when you start seeing people who, you know, was running 50 last year and they running 44.5, you know what's going on. When people drop 10 seconds in March, you know what's going on. So, yo, we had a great time. I hope you liked what you saw today, you know what I'm saying, and give you some motivation to continue running, continue working hard, continue working towards your goal. It's 2020, y'all, January, well, it's February now. Happy Black History Month. We started off on a good time. Who you got for the Super Bowl?
I'm going to go with the 49ers.
49ers, okay. I have no idea, because I'm just going for,
I actually do want the Chiefs to win, just because it's a black quarterback.
Oh, yo, that's a great point. Black quarterback. So that's what I'm picking. If that's what we're going on, I'm going for black. Always bet on black. All right. With that being said, we're out. Peace. Hope you have a great day. Trackheads, it's D. Brown and Farrar. Peace.